Guys, why is it still 103 degrees outside and it's mid-September? Where is my fall weather? I am not happy. It's Thea, and I am back with another video. I'm really excited for this video. It's my first haul in a really long time. I've got some great books to show you guys. I ended up going to my library's friend community book sale over the weekend, and everything was super cheap, and on top of it being half off, so I got some great deals on books. I am really excited to dive into these. Most of these are YA. There are a couple adults and a couple mangas, but I am just really excited about what I have here. And also, I ended up getting about 10 books or so for about $10, so I'm super pumped to get into all of these and show you guys what I bought. And these are in no particular order, it's just gonna kind of be what I pull out of the bag. But the first one that I see here is A Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee. I ended up just actually reading this and getting a copy of this from the library. I absolutely loved it. It's one of my favorite reads of 2018 so far. I gave it 5 stars. I loved everything about this book. And I'm really excited that I found this at the library sale for $1. It is a little beat up and it does have like the library binding on it, but that's a really easy fix. And just for me, it's just important that I own it. And since I am on a book buying ban, having to fork out the full price is just something that is reasonable right now for me. But finding this for $1 was absolutely worth it. And I am just so excited that I now own this. And I cannot wait to annotate it and like annotate my own copy because there's so many quotes that I just absolutely loved reading it. So I am really excited that I now own this. And the next thing I see here is actually a book that is the only book that was not actually on my physical TBR, just because I saw it and it was like $1.50. I could not pass it up. I saw the movie a long time ago when it was like first came out, loved the movie, and then just recently found out like a few years ago that it was a book and kind of was like, okay, well, if I run across it, like I'll get it and kind of read it and see what the difference is. And then I saw it at the book library book sale for $1.50, figured I could not pass it up, and it's not a library edition, so it's like a regular hardcover edition, and that is The Devil Wears Prada by Lauren Weisberger. I love the movie and I've never read the book, so I figured what better way to go ahead and read it. And it is a gently used edition, but doesn't matter to me. It was $1.50, so it was worth the price. And I cannot wait to dive into this and see how different it is from the movie. And the next book was a complete like shocker that I found. It was on the free shelf of like books, like free bookshelf, because it's an ARC, so you can't like buy it or sell it. But I did end up finding an ARC of Rebel of the Sands by Alwyn Hamilton. I've never read Rebel of the Sands yet, but I'm kind of slowly trying to may have like an ARC collection for things that I find or that I'm gifted, or that I just have. So I just found this and I was like, well, sure, I'll take it. It's free, it's an ARC. And I just love the cover of this ARC. It's just a beautiful copy. So I'm really excited to just have this for my shelf. I will end up reading the finished copy eventually, but just to have an ARC for my shelf that I've been slowly adding to is really great. And the next thing I found was also really, really exciting, and that is The Archive by Victoria Schwab. This is just a regular trade paperback. It doesn't have any library bindings or anything. I've heard that this is like either just really difficult to find or is out of print in general. So when I found this, I just like freaked out. I got this for 50 cents, you guys. 50 cents. I was like freaking out. But I love Victoria Schwab. Shades of Magic trilogy is like one of my all-time favorite adult fantasy series. And so I'm really, really excited to dive into this and just have this for my collection and for my shelves. And I'm just really, really excited that I now own this. The next two are the two mangas that I picked up just kind of on a whim, not really on my TBR, not really knowing much about them, but they were a dollar each. Figured I'd pick them up, give them a read, try them out. And the first one here is Kwan or Kwan Volume 1. I don't know much about this. I just read the back and it looked like something I might enjoy. I'll read it for you guys here. It says, "In the mystical land of ancient China, where magical beings intermingle with everyday life, Kwan is a strange boy who devours demons and absorbs their powers. However, he's looking for more than a quick bite. Kwan's quest is to find the sutra known as the Essential Arts of Peace. an ancient verse that will reveal the ultimate purpose of his existence. It just sounds like something that I might enjoy. The cover's really cute, so I figured I'd pick it up and give it a read and give it a try. And the other manga is also like a first volume in a series, and that is PhD Fantasy Degree Volume 1. I don't know much about this. I saw it was like $1, figured I'd pick it up and give it a try. It says here, Episode 1, Demon School Hades. Sang is a fearlessly spunky young girl who is about to receive one hell of an education at the Demon School Hades. She's on a mission to enroll in the Monsters Only class, so she meets up with the creature clique that turns her into a vampire. Now Sang can focus her monster articulation on what's really on her mind, acquiring a mysterious magical ring from the fiancé of the chief commander of hell. That just sounds like a lot of fun. So I figured I'd pick it up and give it a read and give it a try. And called Uwe by Frederick Backman. I read this last year, I believe, and absolutely loved it. It was the second Frederick Backman novel that I had read, and I fell in love and I loved it. And so I saw it again at the library book sale for $1. This one is a little beat up. It's not in the best of conditions, but it's just something that could be a copy that I loan out to people, but I'm just really excited to have this back on my shelves. And the next book I actually picked up for my boyfriend, but I figured there's probably people who might be interested in it as well, so I figured I'd show you guys. And that is The Silmarillion by J.R.R. Tolkien. This is the second edition. The cover is really nice. I really like this cover. And it's basically in like brand new condition. And again, this was just $1. And I don't know much about this. I just kind of know that it's an extension of Lord of the Rings. So I figured I'd pick it up for him. And I've never actually seen this edition. I always see the mass market paperback edition, which we own. But we're trying to collect some nicer editions. And I saw this. And so I figured I would pick this up for him. And eventually when I get around to reading Lord of the Rings, I'll probably pick this up and read it as well. And the next thing is the last of the paperbacks, and that is The Demon King by Cinda Williams-Chima. This is the first book in the Seven Realms series. I've heard nothing but great things about the Seven Realms series, and I've heard that her new series is like a spinoff to this series, and you have to read this series before you read the new one, and the new one I'm really excited to read. So I figured I would definitely pick this up and give it a try. If I liked it, then I could continue on. It's quite a chunker. It's bigger than I was expecting. It's like 500 pages. Again, this was $1 as well, and it's in like basically almost brand new condition. So I'm really excited to dive into this just see what the hype is all about. This is another book that does have like the library binding on it, but again, it's something I can deal with. And this is The Wrath and the Dawn by Renee Audier. I know that this has really mixed opinions, and I've been wanting to read it, but again, I just can't justify spending full price if it's not something that I'm going to enjoy. So when I saw this for $1, it is a little beat up, the spine is busted a little bit, but for $1, I couldn't pass it up, and if I enjoy it, I can eventually kind of buy a brand new copy, but this is just something that I've been wanting to read, and finding it at the library book sale for $1, I could not pass it up. And then second to last is The Kiss of Deception by Mary E. Pearson. This is the first book in the Remnant Chronicles. I've heard really good things about it, but I've also heard people who don't really enjoy it. So I'm really curious to kind of see what my opinion is on it. And again, this is something that I've been wanting to read, but I can't justify spending full price on it if I don't enjoy it. So what better way to pick it up than at a library book sale, support my library, get it for $1, and pick it up and give it a read. It is not in the greatest of conditions, but again, it's something I can deal with, and I can deal with the library kind of edition of it, and give it a read, and hopefully if it's something I enjoy, then I can pick up my own brand new copy. We have come to the last book of this haul. It is the biggest book in this haul, both in size and page length and weight. And that is A Little Life. I don't know how to pronounce the last name, so I'm not even going to try because I don't want to butcher it. But this was all over BookTube like last year, and it's just something I've been wanting to read for a while, but because this thing is, an adult literary fiction. It does not come at a cheap penny, so I wanted to kind of wait until I found a used copy somewhere or just had the funds available, and I found this for $1.50, and again, it's another library copy, but I can work with that, and it is a little busted. The spine's a little broken, but it's something I can still enjoy. I can still read it, and I feel like this is going to be something that I really, really enjoy, so I cannot wait to dive into this. Here are all of the books in from my library book sale haul. This is a lot of books. This is like the most books I think I've ever bought in one sitting, aside from like a book at work haul like 2 years ago. But I'm really excited to dive into all of these. There are some new things in here that I didn't have on my TBR. Some things that have been on my TBR for a while, and I'm just really excited to dive into all of these. And they were great finds, they were great prices, and so I'm just really excited to dive into these and make some room on my shelves. What have you guys hauled recently? What are you reading? If you've read any of these, I'd love thoughts, opinions, comments. As always, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit subscribe and click the little bell to get notified of when I post new videos. I hope you guys are having a great day. Happy reading, and I will see you guys in the next video.